Hi, my name is Philippe, and in this video, I'll talk about all the new things available in the new Missive version just released today. All right, so first item, and it's all about the OpenAI integration. So first, now if you open the sidebar, click the cut icon, you can select in between GPT-3.5 turbo model plus the GPT-4 model. So this one is faster, it generates content faster. But it's less perfect. This one is slower, a bit more expensive to use, but the answer are way better, right? So you can play in between the two to see which one fits the task that you want to achieve. All right, so this is the first thing. Let's use a GPT-4 for the demonstration. Okay, now, second point, reply using counter responses as embeddings. So that means that now when you reply to an email, using the prompt and the OpenAI integration, the AI is going to have access to your related canned responses as a source of knowledge to be able to reply using real contextual data based on your own business. If I open my canned response in this demo, can I get a quote, suggest a tool? Can I get the same deal as I got in a previous year and then explain why not? And then when should I order my conference badge? So if I go and reply to an email like this one, we are running a conference next June. Would you like to partner? So I can click here, then I can click on this new quick action reply using my canned responses. As you can see here, we would be happy to explore a partnership for your conference in June. To get a quote, please use our free quote tool, which linked to the tool that was linked in the canned response. All right, same tool, same link. And the cool thing is that if you use bold, italic, underline, or you had link in your canned response, the AI is going to be able to reproduce that same thing in the reply itself. So might use bold to highlight some words you had in the canned response. We'll do the same in the reply generated by the AI. So that's pretty cool. That's really going to improve the quality of the response. Okay, now what's next? Responses are now streamed. So I can do a demo here. So this is a long email and I want to use the summarize action. And as you can see now, I see the result live in the sidebar. As previously, we would only show you the result when it was all generated by the AI, which could be really slow and sometimes could even fail if it was more than 30 seconds. So now you instantly get a preview of what the AI is returning. And so this is pretty awesome. If I go back to my email here, so let's stop this one and let's close it. All right, maybe here I can say improve selection, make it longer and more professional. All right, so you see, I get the result live. And I could stop the action by clicking the icon again, right? So if I want to stop, let's say it's not what I really intended, the result is not good, I can stop and try again. So this is pretty cool. Now, we also have the send and snooze shortcut. Okay, so this is all about what was released in the last two version, which we haven't covered with video, so I'll do it quickly here. So we now offer the send and snooze option. So whenever you reply to an email, you have the option to send and snooze it in a few clicks, right? As opposed to previously, you had to snooze and then send. So it's just a shortcut. And today we also release a keyboard shortcut that goes with that new feature. If I go to what's new, we also now have a pretty useful remove formatting tool for draft. That's especially useful if you draft, if you paste some text and it's full of different, styling. Now you can select text and just remove the styling like that. What's next? All right, this one is pretty amazing. You've probably seen it if you're receiving a lot of newsletter. So now, for most newsletter compatible, you can actually do one click always at the same place, always at the top of the email. You press one click, and what we do behind the scene is that we send an email to an email address that is tied to that exact newsletter. And when the newsletter sender receives that email, automatically unsubscribe you from the newsletter. So that's pretty much it for the last two release. I really hope you enjoyed those. So have a nice day, everyone. Cheers.